Good morning, everybody. Welcome to the Dolatram College orientation. We will begin exact at 11 a.m. Testing the mic. Omkar, are you able to hear me? Am I audible?
हेलो
हेलो गौरव, आप ओमकार को होस्ट बनाओ ना।
ओमकार सर ने ज्वाइन कर लिया?
बस ज्वाइन कर रहे हैं।
नहीं, अभी तक तो करा दिया उन्होंने।
ओके,
हेलो हेलो,
गुड मॉर्निंग गौरव।
गुड मॉर्निंग मैम। मैम ओमकार सर को होस्ट बना दिया है।
हाँ
ठीक है,
या
अब आप
ओके
सबको एडमिट कर सकते हैं। ठीक
या ओके
है, यूट्यूब पे आपने चेक कर लिया होगा, वो लिंक पे क्लिक करके
यस यस इट्स
लाइक।
वर्किंग
ठीक है,
इट्स वर्किंग। हाँ जी
ओके ओके, थैंक
ठीक है
डियर
मैम।
स्टूडेंट्स, वी विल बी जॉइनिंग शॉर्टली, वी विल बिगिन शॉर्टली। रिक्वेस्टिंग ऑल ऑफ यू टू प्लीज म्यूट योर सेल्फ एंड स्विच ऑफ योर कैमराज। म्यूट योर सेल्फ, स्विच ऑफ द कैमराज।
हेलो, हेलो मैम,
उनका ठीक
हेलो।
सेल।
हाँ ओके मैम,
डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वी विल बी शॉर्टली बिगिनिंग विद द ओरिएंटेशन। आई रिक्वेस्ट एवरीवन टू स्विच ऑफ योर कैमरास एंड म्यूट योरसेल्व्स फॉर बेटर बैंडविड्थ। गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन, वी विल बी शॉर्टली स्टार्टिंग। रिक्वेस्ट यू टू स्विच ऑफ योर कैमराज एंड म्यूट योर सेल्व फॉर बेटर बैंडविड्थ। आई अगेन रिक्वेस्ट यू टू प्लीज स्विच ऑफ योर कैमराज एंड म्यूट योर सेल्व। Dear students, if anybody is unable to join the orientation program owing to capacity limits of Zoom, not to worry. It is being live streamed on YouTube as well. We will just post the YouTube link on the chat box. So you can also watch the orientation program on YouTube. Dear students, welcome to Daulat Ram College Orientation Day. I request everyone to switch off your cameras and mute yourselves for better bandwidth. Those who have not been able to join the Zoom link because of capacity limits can view the program on YouTube as well. We are posting the YouTube link on your WhatsApp groups as well as in the chat box. Good morning, everyone. Am I audible?
Yes, ma'am.
Good morning to one and all. On behalf of the Daulat Ram College fraternity, I extend a very warm welcome to everyone present today to our College Orientation Day program. Let us all join hands and inaugurate today's program by virtual lighting of the lamp, which symbolizes new beginnings. This will be followed by the college prayer. Next slide, please. I now welcome our principal madam to this program. Ma'am, please accept our virtual bouquet. Next. I now welcome our vice principal to this August gathering. Ma'am, please accept our virtual bouquet. Next. I also welcome our bursar madam, Dr. Pooja Jain, with a virtual bouquet of flowers. Next. A warm welcome to the faculty. I extend a very warm welcome to first year students of 2021 batch on behalf of Daulat Ram College and wish them good luck on commencing their academic journey with us. Next slide, please. Now begins the round of introductions. The chairperson of the governing body of the college is Mr. Mukul Gupta. Next. The principal of the college is Professor Savita Roy. She is a very dynamic personality. Under her leadership and guidance, the college has achieved great heights, and with her focused and progressive vision, it will continue to scale newer and greater heights in future. I now request Principal Madam to deliver her address. Over to you, ma'am.
भी तो नहीं हो रहा, हो गया,
हो गया।
मालिनी, am I audible?
Yes, ma'am, you're audible and visible.
Okay, thank you. Very good morning to all the first year students who have joined us today in the academic session 21-22 for their 3-year undergraduate degree program in different courses. It was a very enriching experience for all of us, including your non-teaching staff, to enroll you online, contactless, in the college. Today, you are going to start with a journey wherein for 3 years, you will be with us in the college under the guidance of your faculty. For any problems, you will be looking at the non-teaching staff. You will be also aided by your teachers through various committees. Before we begin, you must have read a little bit about Dolatram College, but let me give you a little bit of introduction to all of you so that you know where you have taken admission. Dolatram College was established way back in 1960. And when it started, it consisted just of 207 students and barely 7-8 faculty members. Today, the college has got 5,100 students with around 200 teaching faculty members. We have got 18 different courses running in the college. In addition, we have got PG courses for which we take the tutorial classes. There are 7 postgraduate classes which are running in the college, and is therefore is a huge college with a campus stretching to around 30 acres of land. The college has got very high grade. It has been accredited by NAC as A grade college with 3.36 point. And during those days, we had no system of giving A plus grade to the colleges. The college also regularly is evaluated by NIRF, and NIRF has given us 26th ranking all over India. It has got 7th position in science stream, 13th in commerce, and 15th in humanities stream. And this gradation is done by India Today this year, just before the admission. So this speaks volume of the standard, academic standard that we maintain in the college within the system of the University of Delhi. The college is a constituent college of University of Delhi. And all its examination, its curriculum, everything is decided and designed by a very high-powered committee, which is under the control of Executive Council of University of Delhi. The examinations are also centralized. All the 74 colleges, which are constituent college of University of Delhi, their exam is conducted by University of Delhi. And all the admissions are centralized and online. All of you are admitted in the college depending upon our seat matrix through the online admission by the University of Delhi only. So you are welcome to Dolatram College, and in the larger fold, you are welcome to University of Delhi. And we will try to connect you to your desires, whatever you want to do throughout your 3 years, through various activities which we conduct in the college. Now, the college has got variety of students. We have got around 1% students who are PWD students, and they have been given, taken care of, special care is taken by us, and they are provided. Especially all the VH students are 100% getting scholarship in the college. The college also has got different schemes to help and aid economically weaker section students of any category, be it unreserved or reserved category students. We have got around 700 scholarships and the free ships available in the college for all the students. The students are requested to apply for various scholarship schemes available by Government of India or by their respective state governments, and we all process those forms and allow you to have those scholarships. Those who are not getting any kind of scholarship and are needy, they apply in the college, and for them we try to arrange free ships from the college. The faculty and the alumni, they contribute towards that. But in return, we would like all of you to excel not only in your academic, but also in your extracurricular and co-curricular activities. I also would like to welcome the 35 foreign students who are registered to Daulat Ram College under in the various courses through Foreign Student Registry. And I am aware of the fact that you people are having different time zones and inconvenience when you attend the online classes. I request such students to kindly add into the group. We have given you the email IDs. We have given email ID to all of you. But those who are in the other countries, please join us through the email ID. And in case you find any difficulty in joining the classes, email on daulatramcollegedu@gmail.com. Please feel free to interact with your teacher in charges. Please feel free to interact with the conveners of the societies where you join. Now, all of you are expected to join either NSS or NSO. Some of you will be joining NCC. NCC has, we have got 165 total seats under NCC, out of which 1/3 is given to first year students. And very soon, the NCC convener, Dr. Suparna Jain Thakur, will ask you to enroll for the NCC. The NCC practice is done twice in a week, therefore, and the camps are also taken, are held. So those students who are joining NCC, they should know that they will be required to come to college online. They will be required to come to college offline. They are practicing every day. Now, we have got NSO, the National Sports Organization. In the NSO, you have the opportunity to take to play in the ground. We have got huge, big ground. You will be allowed to participate in various games like kho-kho, kabaddi, table tennis. There are many other games which you can participate not only in the college but across the university. There are inter-university games, there are inter-college games, and those students who are participating are given opportunity to hone their skills also. We have got a good sporting facility in University of Delhi. Third is the NSS, National Service Scheme, wherein you will be having opportunity to serve your society. You also will be learning how to make yourself useful to the society. And since all of us are social human, obviously, hand-holding is required. And this opportunity, which is very, very satisfying, and the students like a lot, is given by the NSS. And the convener for NSS is Dr. Rita Rani. Convener for NSO will be Dr. Kavita Sharma, and convener for NCC is Dr. Suparna Jain Thakur. You can contact these teachers, and their information is available in the on the college website. You have to just play around with the website a little bit for a day or two, then you will be able to know the name of the teacher. For any difficulty in the college, when it is offline, we expect the college will be offline very soon, in a month or 2 months. And we hope all of you will be joining us physically, and we will be able to, you know, see all of you going in the different classrooms, labs, on the playground, and practicing and doing your NSS activities very soon. I know it has been a very, very tiring and boring for all of you to sit at home for past 2 years and take your class 12th examination and take also the admission all online without meeting us. Even we miss you a lot. The college has got an auditorium which has a capacity of 1,100 students, and all of you can enjoy the various activities organized in the college through student advisory board, like events are like freshers. We welcome freshers through the freshers orientation, but after that, you will have programs like freshers meet, you have manjari, wherein we have various events. They run for around 2 days, wherein you can perform your, you have debating events, you have got dance, quizzing, music, you have fine arts, discussions on various topics. So these events are, you know, they give you a lot of experience and you must participate. That is what is the college life is all about. And I hope you will be able to do all offline. But in any case, we are conducting all these programs online also. You can participate in those programs and win prizes and also bring laurels to college. The college also has got a very good, well-furnished, huge air-conditioned library. We have got around more than 125,000 books in the library. The library also has got e-resources. We have got in the library a separate section for the braille section, wherein your VH students can take advantage of the resources available. To help them, we also have the recorded lessons, so that they also, when are not attending the classes offline and have got difficulty, the recorded lessons also help them in understanding. College is completely connected with a common Delhi University server, is Wi-Fi enabled. And you will have all the other facilities, like you have got medical facilities, you have got Rangshala where you can perform, you have got conference hall where you can organize the activities. Now, all of you are enrolled in a particular department, and these departments have got associations. For example, if you are enrolled in life sciences or enrolled in commerce, you will have a commerce association and the life sciences association, and these associations are going to interact with you very, very closely, and they will organize generally one or two lectures from eminent personality in your field so that you can learn from their experience. They will be updating you on the latest what is happening in your own stream. So these lectures are very, very useful, and they go a long way in, you know, shaping you and deciding what you are going to do in future. So you should never miss your association lectures, which are very important. Now, you also will have a facility of joining one of those or many of those more than one societies. These societies are dance societies, music society. Dance also has got Western dance and the Indian dance. Music, Indian and Western Photography Society. You have got societies for quiz. You have got debating society. You have got societies which undertake street plays. So these societies are very vibrant societies You've got Fashion Society, which is very, very well known in the circuit of Delhi University. So you can also go to website, and these societies are all linking their this thing group blogs, etc., with college main website. So if you type Daulat Ram College Music Society Alaya, you will know what Alaya has done in the past and what are the opportunities for you. So they will also be looking for talents amongst you, and you can join these groups and also practice or do the discussions and debating through these societies. And these societies are all participating in all 74 colleges of University of Delhi. And not only here, they participate in IITs, Roorkee, I know, Kanpur, I know, Goa. So they go all over India. Across India, they participate and perform. Now, we also have got a 200-seater hostel in the college. The college hostel for now is closed because we are going into the renovation, addition of one more floor, so that we can have large number of students in the hostel. So for the time being, the college hostel, which will be open most probably in the next academic session by July, will be ready for you. And you can take admission in the hostel in the next academic session, which you people have been asking through your email. Many of you have this query. Now, you also will be attended to by medical facilities are here available in the college. We have got WUS, for which we charge you in your fees, 5 rupees. And any student who has got any medical or health issue in the campus will be immediately taken, will be attended to by the WUS, which is a very big health center, which looks after all the university students and the teachers and the non-teaching staff. In addition, we have our own nurse who is going to help you in case of any small little issues, health issues. Now, I request all of you to, when you come to college, you will find this campus is very, very green. The campus is green because some of your seniors have maintained it. Some of your teachers have insisted on the environment. So all of you are requested to maintain the campus green. All of you are requested to maintain the sanitization. All of you are requested to maintain it as a no smoking zone. Further, the ragging in the college is strictly prohibited. And I have not got any case in past 10 years of ragging. So be assured, neither you have to rag your junior when you become senior, nor you will be ragged by your seniors. But interactions are very, very healthy, which I have seen, and it goes a very long way in your life, and you will also enjoy later on. The college has got washrooms which are fully equipped with sanitary napkin vending machines, and please learn how to use insulators so that you keep the washrooms clean and hygienic. As I told you, we have got lot of extracurricular activities, and we also have got lot of co-curricular activities. We have got, in addition, small junior undergraduate research projects, which we will be giving to the interested students, and they would be coming up with the ideas, and you will be able to realize your ideas with the help of faculty. This program is going to be initiated this year only, and we are going to help you to build up your, not only your idea, but also to publish your work in the next 3 years if the idea is good and you are able to work relentlessly towards your topic. This is in addition to your academic activities, examination, etc., that you will be undertaking. And these small research projects will be given to the student, to the faculty, and the faculty will be enrolling the students who are interested in different projects. And the idea of projects also, faculty would be asking you to propose. So this will give you to publish also in the college. The college has got very talented faculty. We have got most of the teachers who are PhDs, and they are undertaking PhD guidance in the university departments. They are all into some kind of development of curriculum. Like many of them are enrolled and writing e-contents for UG and PG courses in e-Pathshala. The college has got psychology resource center where it provides psychological support to the students in need. And for that, you have to just approach the Department of Psychology and the concerned teacher's name will be displayed. The teacher in charge of psychology department is Dr. Rajni Sahani, and she will be able to help you in case you need some kind of help from the department. In case you feel you are stressed out, you need to talk, you are a little bit having anxiety issues, you can just contact the psychology teacher in charge and she will be able to help you. And also your own teacher in charges will also be are very cooperative. Now the college organizes different programs in the for honing your skills. One such program is in-house skill development program, and the in-house skill development programs are conducted for 15 to 20 days. Topics are very, very interdisciplinary, where the teachers they train you your skill for one particular topic, and is consisting of very small group of students. And in the past, we had as many as 2-3 dozens of skill development programs in past 5-6 years, and the students' feedback is very, very good. For that, you can go to the website and see what are the different skill development programs which are to be floated this year. And convener for skill development program is Dr. Meetu Khosla. In addition, the college organizes self-defense training camps, yoga training camps, Swachhta Abhiyan in vacations, and also many such activities which are being organized by the Government of India and the University of Delhi from time to time. Now, University of Delhi is entering into its 100th year, so you will be lucky to witness the 100-year celebration of the University of Delhi. And for that, you will have a lot of competitions and programs from the university also, in addition to what we do in the college. So the college has not only welcomed the new students, it has also a tradition of keeping its old students in our fold through the Alumni Association. The alumni of college is placed very well. Mostly they are in a very high-end jobs, like they are in the civil services. Many of them are judges of high courts. Many of them are very well placed as scientists. Quite a number of them are in the teaching programs. Many of them are principals, vice chancellors of universities. And many scientists are working in very good labs in the foreign universities and the industries. So you have very rich alumni base of this college, which you can explore after you interact with them through the portal. Now, you also have got a lot of other courses in addition to the skill development programs. You have add-on courses which you can enroll. We have got language courses, which this year has already started, and you will not be able to enroll this year. But certainly next year, you can enroll yourself in one of the seven language courses which we are running. The language we are teaching is German, French, Italian, Spanish, Chinese, Korean, Japanese. And these languages, we not only take certificate, we also teach diploma and go to advanced diploma courses, and they go a long way in adding to your CV. We have got add-on courses which are run in the college. Another add-on course is your digital legal literacy course, where we give you idea on how to approach or how to approach redress yourself in the legal system in a simple way, which a common person should know. And this is required nowadays because even if you write a small paragraph or write a chapter or a poetry, the originality you need to know. You need to protect yourself from plagiarism. You need to protect yourself from undue interference in the not only in your public life, but also in the digital domain. For that, there are laws available. And this particular course teaches you what all you can do to safeguard yourself from the onslaught of any negative force. So all these programs are there, and 1465 of you are registered in the first year. And all these programs are useless without your participation. So I welcome all of you to this college and hope in the coming 3 years, you will be exploiting each and every area in this college to the maximum benefit for yourself. And my best wishes to all of you for the next 3 years when you are with us, and hope to see you very soon, all of you offline. Thank you so much.
Thank you, ma'am, for your enriching and enlightening words. Next slide. The vice principal of the college is Dr. Sarita Nanda. She is a problem solver. She has a solution to every problem faced by anyone. She is an overwhelming motivator and provides unconditional support to everyone. I now request Dr. Sarita Nanda to deliver her address. Over to you, ma'am.
Thank you, Malini, for giving such a nice introduction. I hope I can live up to that, image. And welcome, freshers. It's a pleasure to have you here for the next academic session to the next 2 years. And you have already been oriented through the Principal Madam's speech, which you heard just now, when she has told you about the highlights of the college. So my work is mostly done, but I would like to emphasize on few things which you have to do immediately to, embark on your sailing in this year smoothly. You have to do a few things which I'll just shortlist. One is that you have to be part of the WhatsApp group when you are online, because we are still online in the teaching mode. So you have to be part of the WhatsApp group and follow the schedule as they keep on telling you how to do it, maybe through the Google Classroom or whatever it is. So you have to follow those links, and you have to attend the classes as per the schedule, and just like as you do it in the offline mode, that you should have a copy and a pencil with you. Because in last 2 years, what we have seen that the students become very casual because they are sitting at home and they think that just by hearing that they are going to remember everything. But we have seen, it's our experience that you cannot retain things, everything audiovisually. You have to pen it down. So keep a copy and pencil in front of you whenever you listen to any lecture and write down the important notes. So this is one thing. Another thing is that you have to select out a GE course, that is the general elective, For that, there is an orientation which you are going to be, you know, you will be listening to. And that orientation will tell you that what electives are available from the courses which are other than your main course. So you have to select a good GE course for yourself. And besides that, you also have to be part of one of the, at least one of the society or cell besides your association activity. Your association activities are also going to happen. So you have to, you know, keep yourself ready. You should be ready to participate in it. Another thing is you can choose any other society or cell where you can, you know, train yourself right from the beginning and become quite proficient at the end of your third year. So keeping the speech very small, I would thank RTPC convener, that is Dr. Malini Sharma and Dr. Madhu, who is the co-convener. And these people have helped to orient you to the, you know, view of the college and the facilities available. And they will be helping you further in your teaching program, that is selection of your GE, etc., EVS, and your English, your languages, that is AECC and all that. So thank you, everybody, and with best wishes to the freshers who are now going to embark on a new journey, and hope you have you it'll be an enjoyable journey. Thank you.
I think, Sarita, they are also going to get their timetables.
Yeah.
So you will be all be given the timetables very after this orientation is over. There would be interaction by the department. And I hope all of you have received your email IDs, official email IDs. Now, if you have received official email IDs, then you will enter in the classroom through those email IDs only. If you have not received email IDs, you have contact of your teacher, you will approach the teacher. Otherwise, you can write email on the college mail ID, dolatramcollegedu@gmail.com, so that we know who is left. There may be one or two cases, but most of the email IDs have already been dispatched. Also, you have been in the fees that you have paid to the university. The examination fees was included. Now, the examination fee will be charged separately, and for that, we are going to initiate the process of reimbursing the examination fees to all of you as soon as your fees are given to us from the university. So that is going to take few days, few weeks, in fact. So don't worry on that account if the examination forms are filled and you are required to pay the fee. I think the teacher in charges are going to tell you specifically about your department very shortly in the interaction meet, and join them through the WhatsApp group.
Yeah.
Thank you, ma'am.
Yeah.
Next slide, please. Now introducing our bursar madam, Dr. Pooja Jain. She is a perfectionist and is dedicated to the college. She is extremely helpful and always tirelessly works hard in the best interest of the college. Next slide. Dolatram College is a premier college. As Principal Ma'am has mentioned a while ago, it is an AC A grade college. The NIRF has accorded it 26th rank. And as per India Today ranking, sciences have been accorded the 7th rank, commerce the 13th rank, and humanities the 15th rank. We offer three streams, arts, commerce, and science. The motto of our college is to encourage holistic development of students, focusing on not only academics, but also co-curricular activities. We have a sprawling and beautiful campus. The college building was constructed in 1960 and has since been expanded in line with growing needs. Next slide. Shri Daulatram Gupta, a great visionary, educationalist, and philanthropist, was the founder of the college. Next slide. We have 18 departments, over 4,000 students, around 180 teaching staff, and 75 non-teaching staff. Apart from MA, our college offers various add-on courses and foreign languages as well. Next slide. The courses offered includes both honors as well as program courses. Next. 7 departments enroll students at the master's level 2. Next slide, please. Here is a glimpse of combination of subjects offered in our BA program course. Next slide. Here is the list of names of teacher in charges of all departments and conveners of BA program, BCom, and BSc Life Sciences. You will get familiarized with them in your respective departmental orientations, which are going to be organized shortly. The timetable that you will follow on 6 working days from Monday to Saturday will also be given to you by your respective TICs. TICs are a part of your WhatsApp groups that have been created and will be available at all times in case of queries. Next slide. There are some important rules and regulations regarding attendance. A student must attend not less than 67% of total lectures and tutorials or practicals in each semester of each academic year. Out of 100 maximum marks of a paper, internal assessment carries 25% weightage, and end semester exams carry 75% weightage. This 25% of internal assessment saw 5% weightage assigned to attendance. 10% is accounted for by written assignments or project reports, and mid-semester exams or class tests carry another 10% weightage. However, owing to the pandemic situations, there have been changes in these guidelines. Such changes will be communicated to you promptly and timely by your respective department in charges. And let me tell you, in academics, in the past, our students have been awarded university rank holders. Meritorious students are awarded proficiency prizes, instituted prizes, and scholarships on the college annual day. Now, with the help of esteemed faculty and with your own hard work, you all can aspire for university positions and awards. Next slide, please. The college will be providing institutional email IDs to each student, which have to be used by you in a responsible manner, strictly for educational purposes. All classes will be held on Google Meet, and all of you will be joining Google Classrooms. But before that, skill development programs, SDPs, will be conducted shortly to acquaint all the first year students with the requisite ICT tools to facilitate e-learning. All information regarding your email IDs, schedule of SDPs, and so on will be communicated to you through your respective department TIC in your departmental orientations. Next slide. Our college has a very active internal quality assurance cell, in short IQAC, to monitor the quality of teaching learning. The IQAC comes out with an academic calendar in the beginning of each academic session, which gives the schedule of events such as national as well as international conferences organized by respective departments. This calendar can be viewed from the information bulletin, which is uploaded on the college website. Next slide, please. The coordinator of the IQAC is our vice principal, ma'am, Dr. Sarita Nanda, along with other members. Next slide. In accordance with the Gazette notification of Government of India and UGC regulations, our college has an internal complaints committee. Dr. Rajni Sahani from the psychology department is the convener of this committee. Next slide, please. Here are the names of the administrative staff of the college, which are also listed in the information bulletin of the college. Now I introduce Dr. Madhu, co-convener of the TPC, to take over from here.
Good morning, everyone. I, Dr. Madhu, extend my warm welcome to all of you once again, and I'm going to share some important information regarding the college. Though most of the information have already been told by Principal Ma'am, and I'm also going to give you a virtual tour through the college. Okay, so I'm moving ahead with the Department Association site. So in college, each department are having their own association and societies, and all the students are considered to be a member of their departmental association or societies by default. These are the enlisted association and societies of different departments. Next slide, please. Next slide, yeah. Most of the association and society, they also release their annual magazine. Pramila is the annual magazine of Dolat Ram College. Women Development Cell of Dolat Ram College also comes with their annual magazine called Shrestha. Apart from this, other association and society, they publish their annual magazine. Next slide, please. These are a few glimpses of magazine's cover, which are released by different association and societies. Next slide, please. At college level, we have three college level committees, NSS, NCC, and NSO. NSS stands for National Services Scheme, NCC is National Cadet Corps, and NSO stands for National Sports Organization. It is mandatory for the students to join one of them. The NSS unit of the Dolat Ram College basically focuses on involvement of students in various activities of social service and national development. NSS keep on organizing awareness activities like blood donation camp, self-defense camp, yoga session, senior citizen day, cleanliness drive, and many more such vigilant activity. For NSS, convener is Dr. Rita Rani. NCC at Dolat Ram College has a group of around 160 cadets. Every year, the cadets actively participates in various national camps and competition. For NCC, associate NCC officer is Lieutenant Dr. Suparna Jain Thakur. Next committee that we have is NSO. Under aegis of NSO, Department of Physical Education gives ample opportunities to all the students of the college for enhancing their fitness level and personality through training and wellness programs. The department also organizes wellness, personality, gym, and fitness training program for the benefit of the students. Convener for NSO is Dr. Kavita Sharma. Next slide, please. Dolat Ram College has its student union as well. Each year, students elect their union. The union members are chosen from all the 3 years, providing each batch an equal representation. The union posts consist of president, vice president, cultural secretary, joint secretary, treasurer, and proctor. Every year, it is responsibility of a student union to organize activities like Miss DRC, Dolat Ram Memorial Debate, and Dolat Ram Annual Festival, that is Manjuri. Next slide, please. Dolat Ram College not only encourages its students to excel in academics, rather they are equally stimulated to participate in extracurricular activities. We have Committee for Extracurricular Activities, whose convener is Dr. Darshan Singh. Every year, ECA organizes activities like Independence Day, Gandhi Jayanti, Republic Day, and Annual Day. Next slide, please. These are various societies which come under ECA. They include Debating Society, Dramatic Society, Fine and Arts Society, Film and Photography Society, Music and Dance Society, Quiz Society, Poetry Society, and Fashion Society. Next slide, please. These are a few glimpses of the activities being performed by different societies in the previous years. Here we have Fashion Society, whose convener is Dr. Preeti Malhotra. For Poetry Society, convener is Dr. Anita Minch. For Quiz Society, convener is Chitiza Vasin. For Dhara, the Eco Club of our college, convener is Dr. Anju Jain. Aim of Dhara is to make students to explore sustainable ways of living. Next slide, please. Other than these, we have some more societies like CyberCell, whose convener is Ms. Saneya, Enabling Unit, convener is Manjula Rath, Gender Champion Cell, convener is Dr. Meenakshi Thakur, Gandhi Study Circle, convener is Dr. Sachi Chawla. Next slide, please. We have Northeast Cell, whose convener is Boylina Bora, Women Development Cell, whose convener is Dr. Pooja Anand. Dolatram College has a very active placement cell, whose convener is Dr. Kalpana Vash, and we have TEDx DRC, which is convened by Dr. Sonia Mehta. Next slide, please. We have Western as well as Classical Music and Dance Society. For Western Society, the convener is Dr. Prastavana Mohan, and for Classical, Dr. Sonika Sharma is the convener. For Fine Arts Society, convener is Dr. Dipesh Rathod. For Film and Photography, convener is Ms. Sangeeta Gupta. And from Dramatic Society, convener is Dr. Sharda Gautam. Next slide, please. We have a Spikmike Society as well, whose convener is Dr. Neha Niharika. For S Marketing, convener is Dr. Rima Dehel. For Finance and Investment Cell, the convener is Dr. Rita Rani. And for Entrepreneurship Cell, convener is Mr. Nitish Kashyap. Next slide, please. College has also a DRCN Alumni Association, whose convener is Dr. Sonia Mehta. Dolatram College has recently launched its alumni portal and unveiled its logo via Zoom platform. It provides interaction opportunities between the present and the past graduates. Next slide, please. Next. Our college also organizes Inspire Camp for school students, where the students get a chance to visit all the lab facilities of our college, and they also perform hands-on experiment in different science laboratories. Next slide, please. Teachers of our college are not just restricted to classroom teaching, but they are also involved in conducting many research projects. Students from the college also get opportunity to work in these projects. Some of the projects are enlisted here. The science department of the college are part of the star status awarded by Department of Biotechnology, Ministry of Science and Technology, Government of India. Next slide, please. To enhance student skill in different area, Dolatram College has also in-house skill development program. These programs are generally organized during vacation for a duration of around 2 to 3 weeks. Students are also given certificate on successful completion of their courses. Students from any course can enroll in these courses to upgrade their skill. Convener for a skill development program is Dr. Neetu Khosla. Next slide, please. These are the list of the SDP which have been scheduled for academic year 2021-22 by different departments. Next slide. Vidya Vistar scheme is an initiative which is taken by University of Delhi to partner with colleges and department of universities which are situated in remote areas of the country. In the light of objectives of Vidya Vistar scheme, Dolatram College has entered into an academic collaboration with Government College Chauhan and Government Girls College Jodhpur with an aim to enhance the academic capital of the student and faculty. Coordinator of Vidya Vistar scheme from Dolatram College is Dr. Malini Sharma. Next slide. In addition to the 18 courses enlisted in the previous slide, college also offers add-on courses. This year, we have these 4 add-on courses as mentioned here. Dolatram College has also a Center for Foreign Languages, where certificate, diploma, and advanced diploma courses are offered in 7 different languages. Next slide. Now moving ahead with the facilities at DRC. Next slide. College has one of the biggest auditorium of North Campus named as Sadbhavana Bhavan. It hosts cultural and sports event. Auditorium has a sitting capacity of around 1200 students. Next slide. We have a conference hall as well with sitting capacity of around 200 students. It is fully air conditioned, Wi-Fi enabled with digital projection. Inter-college, intra-college, and departmental activities are organized here. Next slide. Next slide. In the premises of the college itself, we have an amphitheater called Rangshala. Next slide. We have a seminar room as well with sitting capacity of 200 students. Next slide. College has a well-equipped library with around 120,000 books and subscription to 43 journals. Library has a computerized database and access. Next slide, please. College has a huge sports complex where sports events are organized and students can participate in their sports. It has a well-equipped gym with fitness equipment. Next slide. College has a hostel with all modern facilities. Student intake capacity of the hostel is around 200. Dr. Sonia Mehta is the serving warden of the college. Next slide. College is also provided with a medical room wherein attendant nurse and first aid facilities are available from 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. Next slide. College has also a canteen where freshly and hygienically prepared foods are available. Next slide. Next to canteen, we have a Nescafe area. Next slide. Inside the college premises itself, we have University branch of Indian Overseas Bank for the student and the staff. The college has computer labs with state art of the facilities. Next slide. College has many research labs and resource center. We have Zebra Fish Resource Center, Drosophila Resource Center, and Psychology Resource Center. Next slide. Departments have their own departmental laboratories to conduct practical classes as well. College has a very active recycling unit whose aim is to make our campus zero discharge campus. It keeps on organizing training workshops to train students and the community. Next slide, please. Here we have some glimpses of the eminent personalities who had been invited by our college and departmental societies. We have visitors from different fields from India as well as abroad. Next, please. Next slide. These are a few more glimpses. Next slide, please. Now, there are two important regulations to apprise a student. First, Dolatram College campus is tobacco-free and no smoking zone. And second one, ragging is strictly prohibited in the campus area. With this, I would end this virtual tour. Thanks. It's over to you, ma'am.
Thank you, Madhu. Next slide. Now, I would like to express my sincere gratitude to the Information Bulletin and Presentation Editorial Board. In the teacher's team was Dr. Sarita Nanda, Biochemistry Department, Dr. Priyanka Singh, Hindi Department, Ms. Sakshi Vaisan from English Department, Ms. Raman Arora, Commerce Department, Dr. Manish Chaudhary from the Hindi Department. My heartfelt thanks goes out to the students' team consisting of Anjali Gaur, B. Honors History 3rd year, Khushi Khandelwal, B.Sc. Life Sciences 3rd year, Muskan Chaparia, B. Honors English 3rd year, Ritika Sachdeva, B.Sc. Honors Biochemistry 3rd year. Instead of outsourcing to external printers, this year for the first time, students have been involved in designing the information bulletin on Canva, and they will be awarded with a certificate of appreciation for their valuable contribution and consistent involvement with the college. I would also like to acknowledge and thank co-convener of TPC, Dr. Madhu, Mr. Omkar Mangla from Physics Department for their constant support. Last but not the least, thank you, Gaurav Apoor, for all the technical part and for making today's as well as all our webinars and events successful as always. Next slide, please. This is another view of our lovely campus. Our college is also very active on social media with a dedicated Facebook page, Instagram, and Twitter handles. Next slide, please. For detailed information on the college, you will be able to view the information bulletin in both English and in Hindi, which are uploaded on the college website. Next slide. I would like to end with a famous quote by Benjamin Franklin: "An investment in knowledge pays the best interest." With these words, I once again welcome the 2021 batch to the extended DRC family and wish all our freshers the very best for the next 3 years that they will be spending with us. The conclusion of today's program is marked by a mesmerizing Odissi dance performance by one of our own students. Have a nice day. I also thank all the attendees for their patient listening. Can you please share the performance? Yeah, thank you.
Na 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 na
Thank you to all for patient listening. Freshers will now proceed for their respective departmental orientations as and when they are scheduled. Thank you.